Rethinking the role of first language in second language learning. Now we come to another article that is looking at the role of the first language in the learning of the second. Now, throughout in the slides that are related to this article, I use L1 for the first language and I use L2 for the second language. These are the same concepts that we have been talking about in the previous models as SL and FL, first language. However, I have changed these to synchronize with the article that you have with you, so that you can easily match the lecture with whatever is written in your article. Now, the question of the first language's role in the second language has been a subject of much debate. Should one use a first language when teaching the second language in classrooms, or should you simply stop all the children and you yourself also from using the first language, or for instance in our context Urdu, when we are teaching the second language in Pakistani context, for instance English? These are the questions, or this is the question that teachers often ask themselves. But whether we like it or we do not like it, more often than not, we find ourselves using the first language, or using Urdu at least, in the classrooms when we are teaching English language. So what impact will this have on the learning of English of our students? Now, historically, L1 has been looked upon as an interference, and they say if you use Urdu, for instance, in our context, it's going to interfere with the learning of English. Over the time, this concept has become more facilitative and has been seen to facilitate the learning of the second language. But if we say it facilitates, certainly the amount of Urdu being used in our government schools does not sort of provide enough evidence for this kind of success. Now, what is the aim of this paper? The aim of this paper is multiple, at least two. The first aim is to trace the idea of the role of first language in second language learning historically. See what research has been saying about it over the time, and then also look at theoretically two of the theories, one related to language learning and the other related to language teaching, pedagogical theory. So in the learning theory, we look at sociocultural theory. What would it say regarding the role of the first language? That is, we assume here to be Urdu. And what will be the role of the second language in the teaching of the second language? And we also look at pedagogical theories. Now, learning theories and pedagogical theories are different. Learning theories tell you how learners learn a language, and pedagogical theories tell you how would you teach successfully. They are linked, but they are different from each other because the focus is different. So the paper actually tries to invite teachers and educators to rethink about their practices and analyze the role of the first language and the L2 learning. And the main argument in this paper is that it allows us, or at least think about accepting the multilingual reality of your classrooms rather than ignoring them. So when we say no one will speak anything but English, we actually try to ignore the multilingual differences and we reject the languages that the learners bring to the classrooms. And we discuss this in more detail theoretically, of course, but we discuss it in detail with relevance to Pakistani classrooms also.